Hi there, I'm Michael, I'm developer by Paessler, and today I'm going to show you how to install and configure your Paessler PRTG OPC UA server. Okay, let's dig in. The first steps are you need to have a license and request that from our customer support. If you got that and have your PRTG instance running, we can switch to PRTG. Okay, in PRTG today we want to export our cloud sensor. So I'm monitoring our Paessler website and I want to monitor that in OPC UA. And for that, the first thing is I configured the tags of the cloud sensor with the tag cloud. And this is the first thing that I note down in my notepad. Okay. The second thing is we need the application server. If the application server is not installed in your system, you can go to Setup, and here, where you can see on my screen, Deactivate New UI, there should be an Activate button for you. Okay, we switch over to the app server, and we're not going to do anything there, we're just copying the URL. And the important part is we use the protocol and the port, both of them is mandatory. And copy that over to our notepad just to have it all together. We in the browser you can see it is not secure because we use the self-signed certificate of PRTG, and by default the browsers are not trusting that certificate. After that we switch back to PRTG and create an API key. This is important that the Paessler PRTG OPC UA server can connect to PRTG. For the name, just use PRTG OPC UA server. And the description is tutorial. The access level is important. We need acknowledgement access. Now we copy the API key also to our notepad. Important here is that this API key is only valid after we press the OK button. So we press it now and it is created. Okay, now let's start with the setup. I start the setup. I agree to the license. You should read the license terms. And after that we can insert our license key you got from the customer support. Paste it here. Let's dive quickly into the configuration options of the installer. Okay, we want to create the configuration. We want to start as a service. We want to manage certificates of the OPC UA server. And just in case, we want to install the quick start guide. Okay, looks fine. And here we need our nodes. First, the host name of the application server. Second, the API key. Also again, copy from the nodes. And for the tag, we use the cloud one. Okay, after the installation is complete, we can choose to open the quick start guide. If you have any more questions, just do that and read anything there. We want to make sure that the OPC UA server is running. So for that, we open the Windows services and look for PRTG OPC UA server. And we can see that it's not running. So now we have to troubleshoot it. Therefore, we go to the program data, where all the configuration is located for the Paessler PRTG OPC UA server. And first, we have a look at the logs. Always look at the logs. Okay, it's already pointing us in the right direction. You can see if you use a self-signed certificate, as I told you in the beginning, I'm using that for my installation. I have to enable the option allow invalid certificates. Okay, let's do that. Open the configuration. That's also located in the program data. And again, we're pointed in the right direction. Also here, allow invalid certificates already commented here. Save the configuration. And now we can go back to the Windows services and start the PRTG OPC UA server again. And now it keeps running. To be sure that our data is exposed via OPC UA, we can open any OPC UA client. In my case, I use the process UA browser and connect on localhost. As a default, we only support security mode sign and sign and encrypt. If you need the non-security mode because of your device does not support any security or encryption, you can also enable this in the configuration file. Okay, click on connect and we can see in the objects of the OPC UA server, root, local probe, first group, the Paessler web services and the HTTP availability, everything is exported now. Just the same as in our PRTG instance. I hope you find this video helpful. If so, feel free to give us a like. If you have any more questions, contact our customer support. Thanks for watching.